Mixed farming system. It is a very important farming system. Let us discuss about the mixed farming system. It is very much applicable to the hilly areas. It is very much applicable to plain area also. It is a very important type of farming. So, friends, I would like to request kindly subscribe and share, like and share to my YouTube channels. So let us discuss how crop livestock mixed farming system facilitate maximum use of lands and animals, resulting into more profits to the farmer. For an introductory, let us discuss. India is basically a rural oriented and the land base with 76.27% of the rural population. Being an agricultural country with one fifth of the world's cattle population and half of the world's buffalo, the cow and bullock are the backbone of the agriculture and play a major role in the rural economy. Most of the farmers are poor, and with small land holdings, which is cultivated with the help of blocks on which they depend for plowing, flanking, irrigation, manuring, threshing, transport of produce, etc. Cows provide milk and milk products, which are the only source of proteins in the vegetarian's diet. The crops and fodder must supply all the nutrients for the animals, such as proteins, carbohydrates, fats, minerals, vitamins, and water for the several purposes to maintain for the growth of animals, weight, production of milk, reproduction of work, etc. Thus, crop animal system constitute the backbone of the Indian agriculture by synergistic interactions of this component of system, which have a positive and a better total effect that is greater than the sum of their individual effect. Livestock converts plant resources of the low nutrient value to high quality products like meat and milk, and also it can be used to control waste in the feral crop systems and promote sustainability. Combining crops and livestock also has an environmental benefit, including the maintenance of soil fertility by recycling the nutrients. So in this topic, I have a certain objective. The number one objective is to understand the crop-livestock interaction and need to mix farming system. Number two objective is to know merits, limitations, and models of mixed farming system. And the number three objective is to know the maximum use of land and animals resulting by profit with the maximum profit from the mixed farming system. So friends, let us discuss what is the mixed farming system. Farming that combines crop production with livestock raising is called mixed farming system. So according to the 12th Conference of Economics held at Chandigarh in 1960, that the farm where at least 10% of its income is contributed by livestock is called mixed farming system. The upper limit of the gross income that is to be contributed by livestock activities was fixed at 49% under Indian conditions. The conference restricted scope of mixed farming to the livestock, which should largely include milk, cattle, and buffaloes. Any extension to mixed farming by supplementary enterprises like sheep farming, goat farming, fishery farming, poultry farming was classified under the diversified farming. Bullocks were not considered as part by the livestock enterprises. In this table, I'm going to show you the two types of farming system here. In the number one, in the cow and buffalo enterprises, where if they give more than the 10% of income, that type is called mixed type of farming system. In the number two, cows, buffalo, sheep, goats and poultry, etc., if their contributions of the gross income is more than 10%, that is categorized as a diversified type of the farming. The livestock is complementary to the crop productions, providing a balance and the protective programs of farming. The above order has been fixed in order to determine the contributions by livestock is adequate enough to result in the mixed farming. The contributions from animal husbandry and agriculture to the gross domestic product of India is more than 13%, including the contributions from the drought power. And this is the image factories in the hilly areas, especially in Arunachal Forest, where depicted the WC field cultivations, and in the other side, I have shown the images of the dairy farming from the Holstein Friesian cows and the Jersey cows, where they constructed the buildings from the locally available raw materials. In such a condition, 70% of the ruminant livestock are found in the mixed farms in the rain pit areas, with complementary in resources by in part from one sector being supplied to the another. In this tabulation, I'm going to discuss that how crop production and animal productions are interdependent to each other. How crop production is going to benefit to animal production also in vice versa. How animal production is going to benefit to the crop productions. The number one in case of crop productions, how they are going to benefit animal production is that crop provides a range of residues and byproducts that can be utilized by ruminants, native pastures, improved pastures, and cover crops growing under the perennial tree crops can provide grazing protein ruminants. In the number two, the cropping system such as LA cropping can provide tree forages for the ruminants. In case of animal production, how they are going to benefit the crop production? In the number one point is large ruminant provide power for the range of agricultural operation such as land preparation and also for the soil conservation practices. Both ruminant and non-ruminant provide manure for the maintenance and improvement of the soil fertility. In many farming system, it is the only source of nutrients for the cropping. The number two point in case of the animal production is the sale of animal products and the hiring out of the draught animals can provide cash for the purchase of inputs in crop productions. Animal grazing vegetations under the tree crops can control weeds and reduce the use of herbicides in the farming systems. Thus, it is proved that crop productions and animal productions are interdependent and complementary to each other. Here are some images I have shown here. In the top left, I have shown that some cattle are grazing in the fodder gardens. In the right top end, I have shown that and there are mixed type of farming where there is a WRC fatty field also. There is also cultivation. There is also dairy farming also. I have shown the sheep farming here. I have shown the poultry farming here. I have shown the figure farming here. Also some cotton farming here or some sort of the mixed farming system also and also a diverse type of farming system here. Now let us discuss the nutrient cycling in crop livestock systems. In the number one point here, organic resources livestock interfaces. Organic resources of the farm and the livestock are associated nutrients and from the ingested feed. Some organic matter may also from the bedding materials for the animals. Feeds in forms of the organic resources livestock interface may take into two forms. Number one form is indirect management in the grazing or the browsing situation, and the number two form is direct management of feed or pasture stall, that is the feeding to the livestock. And also in the next point is the livestock interface. It has a two quite distinct from the interaction. The number one interaction is the production of manure and the compost for agricultural and horticultural organic utility. And the number two interaction is the provisions of the draught animal power. In spite of modernization and the mechanization in agriculture, the use of draught power DAP continues in the Indian farms. Due to the small land holdings and hilly area of the agriculture system, more than 55% of the total cultivated areas is still under managed by the draught animals against the 20% by the tractors. In the sense, still 55% of the Indian system of cultivations is managed by the draught power, only 20% are managed by the tractors. So in this figure, I have tried to show the input, output, and transformation of nitrogen in farming systems, how animals give manures, their dungs, used for the organic fertilizers and organic manure system, and how their urines then becomes nitrification, denitrification, volatilizations, and the nitrogen fixations for the benefits of the soil nutritive values of the soils and for the better productivity. From the above discussion, it comes to know integrations of animal with cropping produce a sustainable agricultural productions. The management system of the different farming enterprises supports rural human population. Also, there are enhancing nutrients and energy flows between the crop and livestock components. So let us discuss on the advantages of the mixed farming system. Mixed farming system well suited for adoption round the year under Indian conditions. 2. Income obtained throughout the year and income is regular and quick. 3. Offers opportunity for better use of land, capital, and labor. 4. Help in maintaining soil fertility by provide balance and the protective type of farming. 5. Reduce risk due to failure, unfavorable market price, etc. 6. Transportation and sell costs can be reduced to minimum. 7. Offers opportunity for complete use of industrial lures. Let's discuss on the mixed farming system. Through the mixed farming system, there will be a creations of additional employment and income. That will not only check the migration of family members from rural to urban areas in search of employment, but it will also improve human population and human nutrition in both rural and urban areas. Other advantages of the mixed farming systems are, number one, revitalization of soil fertility, number two, availability of cheap and clean fuel biogas, reduction of transportation costs, etc. So friends, let us discuss on the different forms of mixed farming system and the use for the maximum benefit to the farmer. The different forms of mixed farming system can be classified in several ways based on land size, type of crops, type of animals, geographical distribution, market orientation, etc. However, the three major categories of farming systems are, number one is on-farm versus between-farm mixing. In case of on-farm mixing, refers to mixing on the same farm only. And in case of between-farm mixing, refers to exchanging resource between different farms. And in case of on-farm mixing, enables the recycling of resource generated on a simple farm. In case of between-farm mixing, it can be used to resolve waste disposal problem where bicrop farmers use dung from the animals for the farms and for their fertilizers. And the number two type of farming is mixed farming within crops and animal system. In this case, this practice involves multiple cropping and keeping different types of animals together. Example, grain legumes association can provide grain with nitrogen. With plant intercropping, farmers can make the most of the space available to them by selecting plants and cropping formulations that maximize the advantage of light, moisture, soil nutrients. Examples of mixed animal system include the chicken production, where chicken dung serves as the pea fodder. Number three type of farming is diversification versus integrated system. In case of diversified system of farming, some component exists as independent units. But in case of integrated system, there is no independent units, but there is a maximum use is made of the resources, making the system highly interdependent to each other. Mixed farming technology contributes to the adaptations to the climatic change, because the diversification of the crops and the livestock allows farmers to have a greater number of options to face the uncertain weather condition associated with the increased climate variability. Mixed farming can also give a more stable production, because if one type of variety fails, another may compensate. So, mixed farming is very much important. Here, the livestock represents means by which family can save and invest in future. Means livestock is a bank where you can save and invest in the future. The livestock is a working bank that can be used and sold during the periods of need. Such as if the crop fails, the farmer can sell the livestock in case of drought or in case of flooding. Thereby, they can save their family earnings. Thereby, they can save around a year and they can compensate their problems, their shortness, and they can manage their family happiness and make family fortunes. So in these images, I have tried to show the drone, the kind of the modern technology, that is the drone, uses of the drone in the cultivation and the farming system. Also, on another side, I've tried to show the drone animal power. In spite of modernization, in spite of drone, in spite of mechanization, is still 80% farming system used on DAP, drone animal power. So friends, those are the references for these articles. I have referred this article from those references, those books, those journal, those international journal, those national journals, and those publications. And thank you so much for watching, and kindly subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you all. Thank you so much.